second and long. Jurassic gets it to Sam Smith. No, Jurassic's on the keeper at the 30, 35, 40, 45 at the 50-yard line. He's running away at the 30, the 20. Jurassic is going to go the distance on the option play. Touchdown, Tigers. 72 yards on the touchdown run for Joe Jurassic, and nobody could catch it. He turned on the wheel.
There's probably some sort of record for Division 5 attendance, too. The fans really behind you, and I think your team would be one of the first to recognize that, you know, that really makes up a big part of it.
Yeah, our fans have been great all year. They followed us all year, and they really came through when it counted, and it helped motivate us during the entire playoff run. And I'll tell you what, I knew we were good, but I didn't know how good, and I think we're pretty doggone good.
Gain of 3 on that one. It's 3rd and 5 for Liberty at their own 27-yard line. Atkinson in the wing to the right side. Going to be a give to Sam Smith. Turns the corner, gets the block at the 30, 35, 40-yard line, to the 50-yard line. And he's going to be knocked out of bounds in Amanda Clear Creek territory. Sam Smith got outside. And I want to tell you, on AstroTurf, Liberty's looking awfully quick today in the state final. Third down and 3 for Liberty at the Amanda Clear Creek 46. Seth Atkinson in the wing left side. A lot of guys at the line of scrimmage. Jurassic rolling right, getting some heat from the backside. Gets a nice block, throws over the middle. Atkinson at the 30, makes the catch. 25 and down to the 22-yard line. Who was the lineman that came back and picked off that charging linebacker? It was Brad Miller on a blitz from linebacker. One of the linemen peeled back to clear the way, and Joe Jurassic hits Seth Atkinson for a gain to the 22. This is a wide receiver to the left side. On 3rd down and goal to go from the 16. Jurassic back to throw. As time loads up, hit just as he threw. It's in the end zone. It's caught by Andy Silvis. Touchdown, Tigers. Silvis made a great read on the ball because it was underthrown a bit. The defender wasn't watching. Silvis saw it all the way, cut in, and it's a touchdown throw. Jurassic to Andy Silvis.
Your guys knew exactly where to be. You were ready for all possibilities, it looked like. You were in the backfield. Just everything went right tonight.
Yeah, we came to play football, and we've been playing great football the last 4 weeks. And we had a point to prove. We wanted to show that we belonged, and I think we showed everybody tonight that that we belong. And I'll tell you, it's been a long 4 years. I personally, you know, I had my own goals. The team had their goals. I wanted to win this for my father. 4 years ago, he was one of his highlights. He passed away about over a year and a half ago, and I know how he wanted us to get back here and have my son play and everything else. For me personally, it was very emotional. Our team, it just showed you, it's really great to see hard work and dedication pays off, because we've worked on it for the last 4 years, and these kids were great. Our coaching staff just did a tremendous job through the entire playoff run. The fans were great. Kids would. We couldn't work them hard enough. They had their goals set. We talked about a 4-step process, and we took each step, and by gosh, it paid off tonight with the state championship. I can't say enough. I mean, it's fabulous. It's fantastic.
A little bit tough to say who played better in this ball game, your offense or your defense.
Well, you know, the whole playoff series, we've told these kids, let's leave nothing on the field. 48 minutes of football, we played 48 minutes again today. The whole series, we've been playing 48 minutes, and we just, it's a shame it's got to end. I mean, I wish we could play more football because it's just been that much fun.
Rex, we want to congratulate you, your staff, your players, everybody involved from Liberty Center, and we want to thank you for the ride you've given us.
In the midfield, where athletic director Jake Johnson is presenting a plaque to Coach Lindgren, recognizing his 250th career win last week at Wasion. Since first taking the reins of the Liberty Center football program in 1985, Coach Lindgren has led his teams to 6 NWOAL league championships, 16 Ohio High School Athletic Association playoff appearances, 6 appearances in the state semifinals, 3 appearances in the state title game, and in 1997, the Ohio High School Athletic Association Division 5 state football championship. In that period of time, Coach Lindgren has also had 57 all-state football players. With tonight's win, Coach Lindgren is now tied for 24th on the all-time Ohio High School Athletic Association list of coaching victories. Let's have a big round of applause for Coach Lindgren and what his achievements have meant to the town of Liberty Center and to Liberty Center schools. Thank you very much, Coach.
Hey Coach, congratulations, what a great night. I just wanted to let you know how much of an impact you've made on this world. You were a big deal to me, and what you did for me when I was younger was such a huge part of shaping me, because you were a father figure to me, and you helped shape me as a man. These are two things, two gifts that I'll never be able to repay, but what I can do is continue to pay it forward, and that's what I'm gonna do. So all the videos you'll hear, all the people talking about you, just think about how that affects the world. You've done that. And for everyone who says congratulations, for everyone that tells you many of the same things I'm telling you today, let it in. Let it in. You deserve it. Feel how big of a deal you are, because it's pretty cool. For me, specifically, it was as much in wrestling as it was in football. And many people forget how much of a wrestling coach you were and how much you did to shape our lives. But that was great, because I'd have never went to college, ever, if you didn't coach me in the way you did, both in football and wrestling. To get a full ride, that would have never happened. You supported me through all of that. I got a degree. I got to become successful in my life. And it's because of what you did. So for me and countless others, I just say thank you from the bottom of my heart. And I love you. And for everyone else that's there, hi. I would have loved to have been there, but unfortunately I couldn't make it. So enjoy your night. Have a great time, everyone. And I'll see you soon, I'm sure.
Well, first off, Rex, I want to thank you for everything you've done for Liberty Center Athletics. Not only football, a lot of people forget what you've done for wrestling. You came here to this school with a wrestling program that was basically non-existent, turned it into a state power in a very short time. Then you moved from there to football, and which wasn't doing very good either, and won a state championship, and we're known all over the state for our football. And that's all thanks to you. Along the way, you've done a lot of good things, but I think things most important is what you've done for the kids. Not only all the athletes, but all the kids you've touched in the 40 some years you've been teaching, including my kids and my grandkids. Means a lot to all of us. I want to also thank you for the opportunity you give me to help help coach. The first year I did it was my son's senior year. It's a year I'll never forget, but I'm sure glad you let me be part of it. Thank you for that, and thank you for your friendship. You've become a brother to me from back in the days of old-timers football to the golf we played yesterday. We've had so many good times. Cheryl and I will never forget the times we spent together with you and Kay, the memories we made. It's just been a great time. I'm looking forward to the next 25 years or whatever we have together. Playing a lot of golf, going to football games, and just enjoying things. And I just want to thank you for everything you've done for the community, the town, and my family. Good luck to you, and have a great retirement.
Coach Lindgren, 32 years as a head football coach, truly remarkable. Just wanted to thank you personally for all that you have done. This is a really tough profession, and for you to last that long and be so successful really speaks volumes about you. It's been a great ride. really enjoyed having you as a coach and being able to coach with you. I've just learned so much. I can only hope that if I can impact the lives of the guys that I've coached half as much as you have, I'll consider myself a success as well. I wish you a happy retirement. You certainly have earned it. I hope when this ride's over that you truly take some time to reflect on all the wonderful stuff that you have done for this community, and we just can't thank you enough.
Hi, Coach Lingren. It's Jesse Smith, class of 1999. I want to wish you the best in your final year of coaching. Thank you for such tremendous leadership during our state championship run in 1997 and also our state runner-up run in 1998. Thank you for giving my brothers and I an opportunity to play for the Tigers. We surely enjoyed every moment of it. And also want to thank you for the part you played in helping me earn a scholarship to play Division I football. You truly prepared me. Thank you for support during the All-Star Games as well. And I want to wish you the best in your final year. Take care.
My name is Casey Moeller. I was a manager for Coach Lingren during the 1988 season. I played for Coach Lingren from 1993 to 1996, and I've coached with him from 2000 to the present. Probably the biggest lesson he's taught me as a coach is that you have to care for your players. And I've seen him do that numerous times, and the one time that really sticks out in my mind was a Thursday night meal when we invited the seniors' fathers to come and eat with us. And we had a senior whose father had passed away, and Coach Lingren asked if he could eat with this particular senior, and the senior said, "You don't have to do that." But Coach Lingren said, "I'd be honored to do that." And that struck me as Coach Lingren really caring about his players and making sure that, you know, their needs were met at all times. And because of that, I think he's been able to really push players and get the best out of them, because those kids know he truly cares.
Coach Lingren, just a shout out there to you for, I want to say congratulations on a successful coaching career. It was a lot of fun and a pleasure coaching with you over the years. I wanted to say, again, congratulations. You had a great impact on many young men, and just wish you well in the future, and we'll see you out there on the golf course.
Hi, my name's Tom Fry. I've known Rex for a lot of years. The main reason for that is probably because I wrote the articles for the Liberty Center Press for the Tiger football games for almost 23 years. During that time, I've seen a lot of good football, some of the best ever played at Liberty Center. Over Rex's career here, he's had many, many good games. He's had a state title, runner-up titles, two of them. He's had regional championships, NWOAL championships. And by the time he retires, quits coaching, he will have over 250 victories probably. I personally think while his accomplishments are very important, that there's one thing that I think Rex really, really enjoys, and that's the daily routine of preparing for the next game. The practices, the preparation, the competition, and the interaction with his players. He not only gets a chance to teach the football, he also has a chance to teach lessons in life. My son Jason played for Liberty Center back in the middle 90s, and during that, and to this day, he lives by some of the lessons that Coach Lingren has taught the all the fellow Tigers. So Rex, congratulations on a great career. Thank you for what you've done for the town of Liberty Center and the Liberty Center football program and their players. And one more thing, Tigers, keep up the good work, finish out the year. Needs a chance for a playoffs, and we get a chance for one more chance against that team from down south. Go Tigers.
Mm-hmm. Coach Lingren, I want to say congratulations and best of luck in retirement. I had a heck of a lot of fun playing football for you at Liberty Center, but little did I know that you were crafting me into becoming a great, successful man. You did that by teaching me that I needed to prepare every week in order to get better. I had to work hard and I had to stay dedicated to my goals. You know, it's something that I wasn't thinking about much when I was a young teenage boy playing football for you, but it's came into my life every single day since then. And I've used it to give myself a successful career, and I attribute a lot of that to you. You're like a second father to me and a great man, And once again, I just want to say thank you and best of luck.
All right. Good afternoon, everybody. Despite that, you know, one of the voices of the Tigers on for the different sports. We talk about Rex, and a lot of people have said some good things already about him, and you'll hear more good things. I want to give you a little different shake. Some that don't know Rex very well might say that he's loud, boisterous, and brash, that he's a menacing manipulator. But then if you ask the people that really know him, they might say he's even worse than that. No, really, though. What Rex has meant to Liberty Center High School is just out of this world. The mystique of LC's tradition and Rex bringing his own special methods of motivating the kids has been outstanding. I would say we could be the most unique school in the state, if not the whole country. Rex can take these kids and has this innate ability to tear them down and then turn right around and later in the week build them back up to be ready for the final game crescendo. He turns slobs into studs. He turns lazy boys into intense, finely tuned men machines. He instills respect, desire, and dedication. And what more do you want out of a program than that? Now, the one thing that I personally know about Rex is that when my son was on the football team during the state championship and the state title runner-up, was that my son, while he didn't ever start a single game at Liberty and didn't always get in the game, Rex put this love for the game and the love for the team ahead of everything else. And my son, although not a non-starter, still won the Ironman Award two straight years, his junior and senior year. Now, that's the kind of stuff that Rex brings to our team and our town, and we are very fortunate to have had such a terrific guy. Thanks.
Congratulations, Coach Rex.
Thank you for coaching my dad.
I love Liberty Center football.
Thank you for all of your wins.
Thank you for letting me go in your swimming pool.
We love you, Coach Rex.
Congratulations, Rex. We just want to thank you for bringing wrestling back to Liberty Center. We had no wrestling team. The kids hardly knew that what wrestling was when you came in, and you just brought wrestling back. And we had a grandson who went to state under you, and all of our grandkids played football under you, and our nephews, and now the carpenters, and more nephews. And we just thank you for all you've done for the Liberty Center school system, and we love you.
Well, Rex, I can't tell you much more. After the season went over, everything pretty good. the first thing I'll tell you, Rex, I've really enjoyed you being here at Liberty Center. You really brought sports back, and I got to congratulate you how good you've done on the wrestling. And you know, you and I know how much fun we had together, and you've done such a wonderful job helping bring this football program back like it is. And you've just done, I just cannot tell you, Rex, how much fun I've had with you all the time you've been back here, up here living. We've had a lot of good times, and it's going to be on my mind, or I'll never forget all the good times we've had, Rex. You've been so good to me, and so all I can tell you is I want to congratulate you again, Rex, on the wonderful job you've done here at Liberty Center.
Yeah, I remember when you first came, Rex. Kay didn't have a job. I gave her a job at the Liberty Press. I was the editor there. And I gave her a job so she'd have a job. And I think you came as a teacher, if I remember correctly. And then pretty soon you were coaching wrestling, because I remember you told us one day, them kids don't even know they don't think they can wrestle. They don't really think they can. And so it was a joy having you and Kay at Liberty Center.
Rex, I can't tell.
Hit.
She must have heard that from me, Rex. But anyway,
that was Kip's old thing.
But anyway, Rex, I I have to tell you again how much I appreciate you being here and how good of a job you've done. And we think the world of all of you. We just hate to see you leave, Rex, but we know that you have been here a long time and ready to relax.
Yeah, and one grandson was center when we went to state in one state. Kenzie, go Tigers!
And anyway, Rex, we also appreciate how much you've done for our five grandsons that went through under you in football. You made really, really good young men out of them, and we appreciate that very much.
Yep. And our nephews. We've had lots of nephews under you. Yep. Even Ray said he played. Did you play under Rex, Ray?
No.
No? Okay. I guess he did. I guess.
This okay. is about all I got to say, Rex. So thank you very much for appreciate me asking me to come up and see you to speak to you.
I just hope we have some football after you leave.
And I hope we win tonight, Rex.
Mr. Lindgren, my eyes have seen you in many different ways. First, you're my hero and my idol. I love watching you play old-timers football with my brothers. Watching you carry the ball and carrying so many people along with you. And I love now hearing you tell the stories of you playing old-timers, and every time you tell the story, it took more and more people to take you down. Then you were a teacher to me. I had you for family living, and I'm sorry, but I have no idea what I learned from you there. All I remember is you getting your shoulders rubbed constantly during class. I am so thankful for that day that you came to Liberty Center to interview for a teaching job. There was no school down there that had been burnt down. All that was there was a house trailer. And you still went ahead and took the job. I am so thankful for that. A few years after Carl and I got married, you became a friend to me too. I have loved and cherished the times Carl and I have spent with you and Kay. We loved going out to eat with you, going to the redneck auctions, a vacation with you. We just cherished that time together. I have also seen you as a good friend to Carl. I know how much he enjoys spending time with you and golfing with you and just the times that you spend together in coaching, and I know you love to tease them and call him old. My children have also had you as a teacher and coach. Neil has learned so much from you as you taught him and you coached him. He learned patience from you. He learned to wait his turn as a player out on the field. And then when it was his turn to be that player out in the field, he learned from you to be a team player and to give it his all. Sorry, but I think all that Chelsea learned from you was to do squats. Then when Kay got sick, I saw you as a man who loved his wife, and our hearts ached for you and your family. This community will never know all you have done for the kids in the school. You have taken so many kids under your wings and looked out for them. There are so many past players who have come back to help you coach just because they still want to be part of the Lindgren football. I want to congratulate you, Mr. Lindgren, on 250 wins and an awesome coaching career. I am looking forward to a vacation with you in March. And no, I am not going to clean your house, and I am definitely not going to do any of the other things you suggested. I just want to know that I see you as an amazing man. Thank you for everything, Mr. Lindgren.
Hey, Rex, Ray. Thank you and Kay for everything you've done. And the kids, I watched them grow up. And you've been a friend of mine. I miss Kay just like you do. It's rough, but to win 250 games in the NWL League, that's unbelievable. You were a great friend of mine, and I enjoyed when you coached wrestling at Liberty. We had a lot of fun. Now, you're gonna move on, and you can play golf all you want, and you and I can go play Texas Hold'em. Just remember, throw a good hand away and make a better hand later on. I enjoyed you being here at Liberty. It's been a lot of fun. God bless. Good luck. Go Tigers.
Rex, on behalf of the Liberty Center Athletic Boosters, we want to thank you for the years of contribution that you've made to not only athletics, but our student athletes. The things that you've taught people, my family's been affected by it firsthand, and you've taught much more than football. And that, sir, will live on for generations. Thank you very much. Thank you from the community, and mostly thank you from the Liberty Center Athletic Boosters.
I've always wanted to thank you for announcing on the radio that the only reason I got to play as a freshman was because my dad was a coach, not the fact that we were down with some guys and injuries. And I still think that you owe me about 1,000 pizzas for repeatedly beating you in badminton, no matter how many times that you cheated. And congratulations on your retirement.
Hey Rex, just wanted to say thanks, let you know that every day being with you has been a privilege and an even greater honor. And I thought I would take a few minutes here and talk about something very important with you. We're gonna need to talk about portion control as you move on in your full retirement. So I'm gonna sit down here and we'll go over a few things. We'll start over here with cookies. Here you can see the football coach, Rex Lingruen portion. And right here you can see the retired coach portion. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get this one, we're gonna put that away since that portion no longer exists, and we're gonna leave with this portion. Let's go here to the middle and let's look at pie, because I know you kinda like pie. Here we have the head football coach Rex Lingruen portion. We're gonna get rid of that. And we're gonna show the fully retired Rex Lingruen portion. And we'll let you keep that right there. Now, for the big one, let's look at ice cream. Here is the head football coach Rex Lingruen portion. No longer exists. This has to go away. And finally, the retired football coach portion is right here. Doesn't that look delicious, Rex? When you look at all three of these together, they look pretty good. But remember this, in retirement, you're only gonna get to pick one of these with each meal. So if that doesn't entice you to come back for another year, I don't know what will. Thanks for everything, Rex.
From your last mom's club, thank you for 32 years of making our boys into men. Hit, Tigers, hit!
Slingering, this is Tim Myers. I just want to leave you a short, quick video in appreciation for your retirement as the head coach of Liberty Center football. Coach Lingren, I just want to talk about three things that you taught me as a player, not only as a football player, but in life. Number one is discipline. That was one of the major things that I learned as a player for you, was discipline. Number two is work ethic. Work ethic is so important. When you got to show up to work, when you don't feel like showing up to work, when you got to lift weights, when you don't feel like lifting weights. And number three, which I think is most important, is the mental toughness that you taught us as players. I remember when we had two-a-days, and at the end of the two-a-days, you say, it's time to go grab the weights, and so we can run hill sprints. It took that mental toughness to do those things. So Coach Lingren, I use all three of those things today, in life today, so I appreciate those things. Now on the humorous side, I want to just kind of go back for all you parents out there that maybe didn't know all the things that was going on behind the scenes, on the field, in practice, maybe a little bit on the humorous side. But I remember as the quarterback, Coach Lingren would have his plays ready for the game. And, you know, I always had to, after the play was over, I'd have to run over to Coach Lingren to get the play. And normally the first 10 plays on offense was either wing right 30 trap or wing left 31 trap. But after we got through the 30 traps, I would come over to the sideline, and I can still see it to this day. Coach Lingren, you know, after he said all those 30 traps, you know, he'd kind of get mixed up a little bit. He would say something like this. Strong ring right. No. Deacon's right. Jet
motion 46 trap boot pass cross country and tell some bowler to block. And so then I'd run back to the huddle and I'd have to repeat that two times. And after the second time, then I would say, Cibola, block. And most of the time, Cibola would say, shut up, Myers. So those are one of my fond memories. When Coach Slinger would stumble over the play, and by the time I got back to the huddle, I normally couldn't even remember what the play call was. But number one of my favorite memories of Coach Lindgren, it was crazy. It would be basketball season, track season, and it wasn't football season. And so I would finish practice, or maybe I was out at track practice, and all of a sudden I would see his van come around the corner of the school building. Or most of the time after basketball practice, I had my gym bag, I was done with practice, I was tired, I was worn out, and I was just about ready to hit the door to go home. And at the very end of the hall, out of nowhere, Coach Lindgren would appear. Every time it seemed like he would just appear out of nowhere. Like he was just looking, always looking for somebody to pick on. So I just about ready to hit the door, and at the end of the other hall, I hear, Myers! And when I heard that voice, it was paralyzing. Because I knew I'm ready to go home. But I knew what Coach Linger was going to say next. So I would turn around. I said, yeah. Myers! You got a lift? I said, Coach Slinger, what do you mean I'm going to lift? I mean, it's basketball season. It's track season. And Coach Slinger would always end it like this. Do you want to play next year? Then you better hit the weight room, buddy. Coach Slinger, appreciate all the memories. Thanks for your time. Hope you have a great retirement. Thank you. Tim Myers, North Carolina.
Congratulations, Rex, on your retirement. Can't wait to see you in Vegas.
Congratulations on your last year of football and your 250th win. You have had an amazing career and you will be missed. I just wanted to thank you for everything that you've done to support the Children of Liberty Center over the years. You've done so many kind and caring things for children that most people in this community will never know about because you just quietly did it because it was the right thing to do. You've helped so many boys in our community to become men that their parents can be proud of. The boys and their parents won't forget how you helped teach them to work hard, be responsible, and show integrity in good times and bad. Some of Anthony's fondest memories of high school are with you in gym class and on the football field, not to mention in your garage and around your pool, literally. I also appreciate the kindness you've always had for Allison and how you looked out for her in high school. She always felt like you thought of her as one of your daughters. One of her favorite memories is of making extra treats for you on Fridays during football when she made baked goods for the football players. She'll always remember when Cinderella came to visit Quinn for her birthday. When I asked Alex for a memory of you, I'm not sure he would say that this was a favorite memory. He said he remembered that when they would play kickball in gym class, his team would be killing the other team. And just as they came off the field to kick and line up, you would suddenly say, oh, you lined up in the wrong order. That's three outs, switch sides. He claims that his team always got screwed when you did that. Just thought you should know. As he was sharing that, Allison piped in with, oh yeah, he did that in our gym class too. Typical Rex. On the one hand, I can see you saying that it was good because it kept them everyone involved and it kept them competitive, but I think we both know that you would be lying if you didn't admit that you enjoyed getting the best of them in class too. Anyway, thanks for allowing Alex to be down in the field since age 5. He loved every minute of it. I think I counted 16 straight years of Briggy boys in the sidelines as managers. They have truly grown up as a part of LC football thanks to you. Lastly, I want to thank you for your friendship with Chris and I over the years. You've been an important person to every member of our family, and we are truly blessed to call you friend. Congratulations.
I want to thank Coach Linger for putting Liberty Center football on the map. I'm proud to have played for you and coached with you. You've taught me a tremendous amount about football, coaching, and life. I want to thank you for the opportunity to learn from you. It's been an outstanding 17 years coaching with you, and I'm grateful for that opportunity. And I want to wish you best wishes in the future.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Coach.
Coach Lindgren, it's Urban Meyer from The Ohio State University. On behalf of our football team, our coaching staff, and this great state and high school football, thank you for your service of over 30 years of educating, coaching, and mentoring young people. Congratulations. Go Bucks.
Hey there, little man. Congratulations on the last 30 plus years. Proud of everything that you've done. Proud to have been able to be a part of it. Proud to be your son. Proud to carry on the Lindgren name. And most of all, proud that you listened to me so that you could actually be successful. You know, it, certainly if it weren't for me, you wouldn't be where you are today. I just want you to remember that. But, you know, really what you've done, the influence that you've brought on the community and myself, goes without saying the success that you've had. And the people that you've touched, and I really just hope that I can influence as many people as you have. I love you, and let's have some fun tonight.